knowledge continuum expresses itself through fingertips, through what people created in this country. But I think what we really have, and which I think we still have among our ordinary people, is the practice of ahimsa. In the small things that we do, you know, what is so great about this land is that people have figured out everything is connected. And they have built their life with this understanding, that they have built it with this understanding as a core of their lifestyle. So that's for me the crux that has been reinforced every time I've interacted with people. Why do we use reconciliation as a way of resolving conflicts rather than going to aggressive? I mean, this entire campaign that probably originated in the US in the last 15, 20 years of reviving Kshatriyahood in India. I mean, this is such a poor idea. I mean, in Tamil Nadu, where I live, warrior class is not unknown to India. It's not as though people did not know it. But my warriors were farmers. Bulk of my warriors are farmers during peaceful times. They were doing farming. And maybe when they are pushed for it, they would also go to war. I mean, they were fishermen, they were farmers, they were people who were doing other things. Thing is, we got, I think, carried away by the Western narratives of conquerors, victors, and defeat. There is a sense of interbeing. There is a sense of interconnectedness. There is a sense of this is the way we are. When Gandhi put it so beautifully, when he said, if everything about the civilization goes down, if this one line of the first Upanishad remains, Isha Vasyam Idam Sarvam, everything that is there is connected in God. And for this Gandhi statement, for me, becomes more powerful because, not because it is in the Upanishad or not because Gandhiji says this, but because sitting in a small village, listening to experts talk about sustainable development, I had this village headman who sat there for 2 days. At the end of the 2 days, we asked him, okay, you've been listening to sustainable development discourse. What do you think? This man says, according to me, if 100 families agree to live together with an understanding that their lives are connected with each other and with all things around, and this connection is divine, that is sustainable development. Now, I was frozen when I heard this. When I said, like, this is a chief Seattle moment for me. And this is a village headman. I mean, what more wisdom do you need in this country? Somebody tells you, my life is connected with everybody else's life and all the things around me is connected to each other and to my life. And that which connects is the sacred. The sanctity is, and then you expand on this. And you look at a village system today, what all have been made sacred in a village are those things that connect lives and which enshrines the sense of togetherness or interconnectedness, the abandoned people. I mean, I prefer to call them the abandoned rather than the migrant laborers. These are the abandoned people of this country. Let's face it. They were abandoned even before they started walking. You know. And but what we have seen is this outpouring of commitment to the others, nameless people, people whom you didn't know about. This morning in the newspaper, I read about somebody who gave away the money he had saved up for his daughter's education. He just took all the savings and he spent it on feeding the abandoned people as they were walking past his village. somebody else has given away all the money saved up for his children's wedding. I mean, this is the practice, this is the love, this is the life, this is ahimsa of our times all around us. Media wouldn't report it.